Hello everyone, welcome to REACH Mental Health Awareness Series. I'm Dr. Rashmi and today I'm going to talk about exam related stress, and this is Dr. Yesheswini. So as we know, now that the exam seasons are going to start, and most of us go through this exam related stress, not just the parents, the children too. So doctor, can you explain what is exam stress pressure?
I think most parents are quite familiar with this, right? Not only the parents, I think grandparents, if they're living with the child, the whole house understands what exam pressure is. Now, when do you call it exam stress? See, exam pressure is something every child faces, but the pressure reaches to an intensity that it's affecting the functioning of the child. So that's when you say exam stress, which is, you know, some people call it as exam phobia, or exam anxiety. So meaning the intensity of pressure increases where the child is unable to focus, unable to sleep well, unable to eat well, terrified of giving the exam, wants to avoid the exam. So this is what we call as exam stress.
So how can we cope? Not just the child, but the parents. What can be done?
There are a lot of things a child has to do to prevent the exam stress and a parent could do to prevent exam stress. So if we talk about what could a parent do, the first and the foremost thing is ensure that your child gets good amount of sleep. And when I say this, a lot of 11th and 12th graders would say, what do you mean good amount of sleep? I don't have time. I need to prepare for my boards. I need to go for coachings. There's no time. However, again and again, the data clearly says that sleep is absolutely essential and your brain functions really well. You can focus well, that recovery time is needed for the brain during sleep so that you can study well the next day. So adequate, so I would say adequate amount of sleep is needed. So just do not, cram your sleep to a couple of hours because it's not enough. So number one is sleep. Second is nutritious food. Of course, these days you see a lot of teenagers, you know, munching on a lot of junk food because it becomes handy. It's very easy to munch all those, but it's very important to make sure that you're eating healthy and taking a nutritious diet, which gives you the right amount of energy to put in longer hours. Number three is regulate your gadget time. I think this is where I'm sure a lot of questions would be coming. So when I say regulate your gadget time is know how much time you're spending on the gadget. Otherwise, you might be on a gadget unendingly, right? So it's important to see, you know, how much of your time is going into what kind of things. So sleeping, eating, your gadget time, and recreation is very important. So if you're a child who loves to play basketball, take out some time, 30 to 40 minutes. Or do something that relaxes you. Again, the question comes, you know, I'm doing board exams. I don't have time to do anything like this. But I think breaks are extremely important. So if you take care of these things, you can sail through these in a comfortable manner to the best extent as possible.
And I think you can say the same thing applies to the parents as well. Even they need to stay calm, take a break and support their child and not be too over involved and hovering over the child.
Yes, parents go through a lot of anxiety themselves because you're seeing your child struggle hard. So, and the whole environment also is that you know, the whole family is taking exams in a way, right? So what I would suggest the parent is they need to have good sleep. They also need to follow the same things like you said. They also need to have breaks. And as you said, don't hover around the child. Helping the child doesn't mean checking on them every hour. And asking them so many questions. Did you do this? Did you study this? So this is an anxiety translating between the parent and the child. A parent needs breaks. They need to go on with their daily routine as well. Be there for your child, support them, but does not mean that you overprotect them and think on their behalf and you get anxious and thereby translate your own anxiety onto the child.
So not make them your project.
Absolutely. Don't make your child a project. You have other things. You are completely capable of doing this. This is a part of life. You get better at it each year. So show your child that these exams are something very important. They teach you some skills. They teach you time management. They teach you discipline. They teach you how to face a stressful situation. And there are exams in life, different kinds of tests in life. So you need to know how to go over these things. So, and also be realistic. Don't brush aside saying, this is nothing. We have done so many things. Don't brush aside. Keep it realistic. they are difficult, they are challenging, but you can make it, you can go through these things.
So this is true in most of the cases. What happens when there are, you know, extreme levels of stress and anxiety where
child is not able to cope? So when you say extreme levels of anxiety, usually exam stress presents in the form of panic attacks. Some children say that, you know, I can't sleep, I can't breathe, I'm sweating, I'm shivering, so it could be a panic attack. In some children, they could go through mood fluctuations. Some children may not eat well. Some children may have a lot of sleep difficulties. So when these kind of things are happening, you try to conservatively look at some of the, and take some steps, you know, to get their routine in the right manner. But if it's getting too difficult to the point the child is not at all able to focus, is completely in a give up mode, is crying continuously, not at all sleeping, then that's the time to seek help. It helps to speak to a counselor or a psychologist.
Okay.
Yeah.
So do they need medication at times?
If the psychologist and counselor in most cases would be helpful and, you know, try to give them certain techniques on how to reduce their anxiety and manage their stress. However, if the symptoms still persist, they need to be seen by a psychiatrist. And sometimes, yes, if the anxiety is very severe, a medication is prescribed as well. So, we're talking about parent management, we're talking about child management, and most importantly, what I would say is the prevention angle. If you want to prevent exam stress, what should you do in advance? Make sure you have regular study habits. Make sure you have a balanced life. You know, you have some recreation, you're
structured.
Structured, that's the right word. Structure it well. Yeah. And also parent involvement. See, earlier times parents didn't have to involve much, but if you really look at our educational system now, there's a lot more need for parental help because things have changed, the competition is very different. They need to be involved, but over involvement increases the pressure to the child. So we need to take care of all of this if you want to prevent exam stress. But having said that, if you really look at competitive exams, they're very, very difficult. Every child goes through a lot of stress. Again, be there for your child, support them, reassure them.
One more very important thing is what the parents do, comparing the child to the other children.
Yes.
And
So this is a very important point because a lot of parents say, you know what, this is not enough, that child got this, or my sister's son got this. This is not going to help children. So let's talk about what are the things that the parent should not do. One, compare the child. Two, negative statements from the parent. This is not enough. You're not going to get any admission anywhere. You're lazy. So these kind of statements would demotivate the child.
So more of positive.
Positive reinforcements. You can get through these exams. Yes. You're capable of doing this. That would definitely
Unconditional support.
Number four is for parents themselves to handle their own anxiety. Yes, parental anxiety is going to be there when your child is going through tough exams, especially the board exams. It's important for a parent to handle their own anxiety. They need to relax themselves. They need to take breaks. Handle your own anxiety before you handle your child's anxiety.
Okay. Yeah. And in what way the schools can help?
It stems from school, especially with board exams, because the teachers also would be telling them, you know, the board exams are coming, you need to study hard. I think children hear about the pressure, see the pressure, experience the pressure from all angles, right? So it's very important for a teacher to help students take a positive approach towards this. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm sure the teachers are the ones, you know, who have seen many students, right? So give them positive examples, give them strength, give them comfort, reassure them. So this would really help, because if the school is pressurizing them to a great extent, and even if you're very relaxed at home, that's not going to help the child. I think a balanced view is absolutely the need of the hour, both in our schools, homes, even in our communities. You know, we make a big deal of the exams. Exams, of course, are a big deal, but we also need to, we also need to make sure that we take care of our children better, is what I think.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I think we have covered most of the things we are facing today. I hope this discussion helps you. So do remember to support your child and to stay calm, and in that way you'll be helping your children stay calm. So if you have any doubts, please write to us and we'll be very happy to help you in whatever way we can. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for being part of the Reach Mental Health Awareness Series. Thank you for watching this video. We would love to help parents and children and answer their queries. If you have any questions or any topics of interest, please do comment below. Thank you so much.